لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم، وعلى آله وأولاده وأزواجه وأصحابه وأتباعه وخلفائه الراشدين المرشدين المهديين من بعده، ووزرائه الكاملين في عهده، خصوصاً منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق، أمراء المؤمنين حضرة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوا، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر، وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر؟ ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر، تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر، سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. صدق الله العظيم. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. صدق رسول الله ونطق حبيب الله فيما قال، أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear brothers and sisters, we are in the last days of the holy month of Ramadan. Today is Friday, the most auspicious day when the sun rises. Tonight is Laylatul Qadr, the night better than a thousand months. May endless praise and thanks be to our Lord Almighty Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, who has allowed us to reach this blessed month. May salat and salam be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of whose ummah we are honored to be members. I wish you all a blessed Friday and Laylatul Qadr. Honorable Muslims, in the verse I have recited at the beginning of the khutbah, Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the sunnah, in the Surah Al-Qadr, indeed, we send the Quran down during the night of decree. And what can make you know what is the night of decree? The night of decree is better than a thousand months. The angels and the spirit descend therein by permission of their Lord for every matter. Peace it is until the emergence of dawn. In the hadith I have read, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives the following good news: whoever spends the night of Qadr in prayer out of faith and in the hope of reward, his previous sins will be forgiven. Dear believers, we are in the last days of Ramadan, the beginning of which is denotes mercy, the middle of which forgiveness, and the end of which salvation from hell. These exceptional days are the days among which is hidden the Laylatul Qadr, which is better than a thousand months. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in one hadith, search for the night of Qadr in the last 10 days of Ramadan. The Laylatul Qadr is a sacred night during which Allah's grace and mercy showered down, and believers, hearts overflow with love and compassion. The Laylatul Qadr is a unique night that reminds us of the values that we have forgotten and reawakens our blinded consciousness. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam warns his ummah about this night as follows: whoever is deprived of the goodness of this night is like deprived of the goodness of a thousand months. Dear believers, what makes the Laylatul Qadr valuable is the Holy Quran that was revealed that night. The Quran is the Kalamullah, the words of Allah sent by our Lord, about which there is never any doubt. The Quran is zikr, recitation of which is an act of worship. The Quran is al-Furqan, which distinguishes between what is true and what is untrue, as well as what is straight and what is not straight. The Quran is hikmah, in which the divine address and warning are conveyed in all of its nuance. The Quran is mubin, which clearly shows the right path to all people to come until the last days. It is aziz, which exalts both in this world and the hereafter those who adopt his orders as principles and spend their life in line with the Quran. Dear Muslims, in one of his hadith, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exalts some peoples by this book and degrades others. We are exalted when we submit ourselves properly to the Holy Quran. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who imparted its teachings to us, we strive to establish justice, love, mercy, righteousness, and truth in the world. We uphold our unity and solidarity, fostering peace and tranquility. We become the greatest obstacle in the face of oppression and oppressors. We persist in bringing happiness to the oppressed and the victimized. Dear believers, let us view the last days of Ramadan and the Laylatul Qadr as a divine grace and blessing for us. Let us embrace the Quran with our minds and hearts. Let us recite it more, understand it better, live up to end, uphold it. Let us show regret for and turn away from our mistakes and sins. Let's know the value of every night and be thankful for every blessing so that we may have our entire lives blessed. Thus, we may be able to succeed to the Jannah al-Firdaus that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises for His believing servants. Dear believers, during these last days of Ramadan, one of the acts of worship we must fulfill is Sadaqah al-Fitr. The Sadaqah al-Fitr is the expression of gratitude for reaching Ramadan and Eid al-Fitr. The Sadaqah al-Fitr is an opportunity to spread the sense of solidarity and sharing throughout the society. So, let us strive to deliver our fitrah to our brothers and sisters in need. Let us not neglect and forget about the orphan. Let us also contribute to their joyful celebration of the Eid. Let us not forget that whatever we spend in charity and good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace with something better. Dear Muslims, I would like to leave you with these final thoughts before concluding this Friday's khutbah. Dear brothers and sisters, I invite you together with your families in the spiritual atmosphere of our mosques for Eid prayer. We will join together in supplication for our countries, our martyrs, the oppressed people of Gaza, and all our persecuted brothers and sisters after the Eid prayer, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us safe from any accident, trouble, and calamity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let's make it to Eid in peace and well-being. I would like to conclude this Friday's khutbah with our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam following supplication. Allahumma innaka afoon kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. O Allah, you are most forgiven and you love forgiveness. So forgive me and forgive us. Ameen. Ala inna ahsana al-kalam وأبلغ النظام كلام الله الملك العزيز العلام كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى في الكلام وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الدين عند الله الإسلام إلى آخر الآية صدق الله العظيم بارك الله الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على رسولنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شان شرف صفيه فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم انصر من نصر الدين واخذل من خذل المسلمين اللهم انصر جيوش المسلمين وعساكر الموحدين واكتب الصحة والعافية علينا وعلى الحجاج والغزاة والمسافرين والخاضرين والغائبين من أمة محمد عليهم أجمعين اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في فلسطين اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في فلسطين وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في فلسطين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم الأموات يا قاضي الحاجات ويا مجيب الدعوات استجب دعاءنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين اتقوا الله واطيعون إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أقم الصلاة